This video is for you if you're setting up your Clever sync type for the first time and you're using the SFTP or manual sync type. In the last two videos, we walked through setting up your school's and students' CSV files. If you haven't done so already, please review those videos first. Now, you'll set up your Teachers.csv file, the third of the five required files to set up your Clever sync. This file has four required headers or columns to be uploaded. Keep in mind, you might have some additional required headers depending on the apps you plan to connect with Clever, and you can always add headers as needed. First, you'll start with school_ID, which is the school the teacher works at. For example, the teacher in the first row might teach at Marshall_Middle. The school_ID must be one of the school_IDs you added to the schools.csv file. If you have a teacher who teaches at a school you forgot to include in the schools.csv file, you'll need to go add that school to the schools.csv file. If a teacher has classes at multiple schools, they should not have separate accounts or be listed twice in the teachers.csv file. Duplicate accounts will cause login errors. You'll worry about teachers who work at multiple schools later in the process. For now, you should still add teachers who teach at more than one school and just list the school they teach the most classes at. Next, you'll add teacher_ID, which is a unique identifier for each teacher. For example, 0112 or D. Smith. If your student information system doesn't include this, you can choose any unique value for each teacher. Teacher_ID will be used in other files, such as the enrollment file, to tie teachers to the classes they teach. Then, you'll add first_name and last_name, like Diana Smith. After you've added these four required headers, the file will be accepted when you go to upload it. That said, we strongly recommend you include teacher_email, which can make logging in easier when you go to set up a login method for teachers. There are also other optional headers you can include as needed. Once you're done with the file, make sure you've saved it as a CSV file and add it to a folder for safekeeping. Only two more until you're ready to upload your sync files. Next up, you'll work on the sections.csv file.